So what I wanted to talk about today was macular degeneration. And this is quite a big topic because there's different types of macular degeneration and there's quite a lot to talk about. One of the reasons for that is because it affects so many people. It's a very common presentation. We see a lot of these patients in clinic. So if we talk about dry macular degeneration in the first instance, that is the common type of macular degeneration. That is essentially an age-related condition. There are some things that increase the risk of developing it, but essentially, sort of the longer you live, the more years behind you, the higher the chance of having it. How does it affect you? Well, often people get diagnosed with it incidentally. So you go and see your optician, and they see some changes at the back of the eye, and they tell you you've got macular degeneration. And suddenly, this is very worrying, and this is a very new thing. But you're not really having any symptoms. And so we're having these discussions with patients about the macular degeneration and about what they can do to slow down the progression of it. So with dry macular degeneration, what we see it. The way I explain it is it's essentially wear and tear in the retina. You see little changes in pigment in the retina at the back of the eye. You sometimes see little lumps and bumps on the OCT scans that we do. And it is a buildup of essentially waste products from the retina that are not removed as effectively anymore in an eye that has been through a lot of life. And it's slowly, slowly wearing down the function of the retinal cells. In the early stages, you will not have any symptoms. But as things progress, people may experience some blurring, some distortion of images where straight lines look bent out of shape. And it's not a condition that progresses quickly. It's a slow degeneration, usually over years. It can reduce your vision eventually, but it takes a long time to do so. What are some of the things, first of all, to watch out for? Well, if you get a sudden deterioration in the vision, so suddenly, one day to the next, things are looking a lot more blurry in one eye, or a lot more distorted, that could be an indication that the macular degeneration is progressing to the wet macular degeneration form. And it is important to pick this up because this is the condition that we can treat. And so if you do notice a sudden change in vision, always do get a checkup at your optician or at your emergency eye clinic. What are some of the things that we can do? There's not any actual shown effective treatments for dry macular degeneration at the moment. There are a lot of drugs in development. There's a treatment that's come on the market recently, which is an injection treatment, which has shown some promise in some of the later stages of dry macular degeneration. But it does have some significant side effects. So actually, a lot of us are not using it routinely for that reason. And we're looking to see as the drugs develop and the treatments get better, it may be the case that we can offer treatment for this form of disease. Most of the things you can do are things you can do, preventative treatments. And that's things like generally leading a healthy lifestyle, eating a good diet that's rich in leafy green vegetables, avoiding sun exposure, so wearing good category sun protection sunglasses. Not smoking is really important because smoking is one of the worst things you can do for retinal health as well as the rest of your health. So all these sensible things we advise, which slow down and reduce the likelihood of dry macular degeneration. And some of the other things you can't affect. So that's things like genetics. If your ancestors have had it, chances are if your family have been affected, you're at higher risk. And being Caucasian, actually, so light coloured eyes are more likely to get macular degeneration than darker coloured eyes. But ultimately, it's not a disease that's going to dramatically and quickly affect your vision and lifestyle. And it's something that we can manage and look after. And only a small proportion of patients will develop problems that are significant for them.